Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm meadsy69. Welcome back to the channel. What in the world is wargaming smoking? What on earth are they smoking for this tank to come in the store for this price? Yes, it is the Shinobi, and it is for sale for only just 10,000 gold. Yes, 10,000 gold for a tier 5 tank. However, it is down from 15,300, so grab yourself a bargain, right? No, stay away from this tank. Not only is it just 10,000 gold for a tier 5 tank, it is a useless tank. It's crap, it's shit, it's not great, and you'll be wasting your gold if you buy this tank. Yes, it is rare. I understand the tank is fairly rare, but that doesn't mean it is worth that price. Now, why is it that price? It's simple. There's two reasons. One is what we've just said, it's rare, and two, it is one of the best credit earning tanks in the game. Now, does that justify the 10,000 gold sale? No, it doesn't. Especially now, because you can earn that. You can earn that credits anyway in a different premium tank. You can earn that credits in a tech tree tank in any tier. Like above, say in tier 10, if you get an ace, you're going to get 200 or so thousand credits. I just can't believe when Wargaming put these prices on. At least it's for gold. I mean, at least it's not for real money. But still, 10,000 gold for a tier 5 tank. I just sit there and think, Wargaming, what are you smoking to be putting it in store for that price? Like, what do these technical teams, what do these teams that work on the store think of when they're putting this tank in stores? Do they sit there and think, do you know what? Shinobi, we need to put this tank in store because this is going to sell like hotcakes. I don't know what they think. Do they think it's going to sell for that price? I mean, you're going to get the odd person, yes, who's going to buy the tank, of course, because they're collectors and they might not own the tank. But for 10,000 gold, come on, seriously. I bought this when it was first on offer. I bought this and I paid probably about £10, maybe even less than £10, £8, £7, something like that. Would I have paid 10,000 gold for the tank? Hell no. No way I would have paid 10,000 gold for this tank. Now, I do admit it does make good credits, yes, but so do the other tanks now. So do the other tanks. Now, you're going to watch this game. At the moment, we have only got 1,000 damage, which is not a lot, really. But this is all this tank can do. Yeah, it's very hard to carry. It's got, the gun is meh. It's got no gun depression. It's got no DPM, really. And it's got no armor. Like, the tank itself is actually really meh. 58,000 credits. So, okay, yeah, that was a decent amount of credits in that battle. That was a decent amount of credits. But let's not have a look at there because they're all test tanks. But let's just have a look. So, it's not great. 60,000 credits, okay, it's okay, but the price, it really is not great. So if you're sitting there, if you're one of the guys that are sitting there thinking, okay, I need the Shinobi, I need the Shinobi, do I buy it? I mean, I'm a collector, it's the only tank I haven't got, do I buy it? I mean, that then is totally up to you. If you're a collector, then okay, if you've got the gold sitting there, some collectors have got 50, 60, 70,000 gold just sitting there waiting for tanks like this to come into the game. Then if that's the case, then yeah, of course, 10,000 gold won't really hurt you. But I still think you're stupid if you do buy it. I know they've got the bundle as well where you pay £5 and you get either the tank or 2,500 gold. Now, I suppose that's not that bad, but it's still not great. So we got a lucky bounce there from the gargoyle, to be honest. We got the lucky bounce, but we do manage to take him out. So we just want to cap this base now, and we're going to see what amount of credits and what amount of damage we can get in this game. Because, to be honest, credits are not even that important now. Credits are only important if you're a new player. Like, I've been playing for so long, I don't need credits. So if you're one of those guys that hasn't got the tank but don't need credits or anything like that, then yeah, of course, don't get the tank. I've kind of given up on being a collector. I've kind of like realized after only over 400 tanks that it's not cool like spending all this money on in a pixel game. No, it really isn't cool. Am I ever going to play the tank? No, of course. And that's what you got to sit there now and think, like, in this day and age. Back then, I used to just buy anything that was in store. Now, I actually sit there and think, right, am I going to play this tank? If the answer's no, I won't buy the tank. I won't buy it because it's just totally not worth it. Why are you going to spend 10,000 gold on a tank just to keep in your garage that you're not going to ever play? And that's what I think of now. So no, apart from making videos, I mean, I haven't played the Chinu Kai since the last time I made a video on the Chinu Kai. So that's what I mean. It's not worth it. Stay away. I don't know what Wargaming are smoking when they put these kind of offers into the store. 1200 damage there, 50,000 credits. I could earn that in tier 10 quite easily. So yeah, stay away from the bundle, guys. It really, really isn't worth it. It's just way too much, and they're just trying to rob you blind, especially with everything coming, the Blitz Fair, the auction, you know, save the gold. You'll be able to spend that gold on something much, much better. So I hope you enjoyed the video, guys. I'm Meadsy69, and I'll catch you all soon. Bye-bye. We'll be right back.